Let's get some perspective from Makurdi of the Benue State Capital, where the Chief Press Secretary to the Benue State Governor, Teve Akase, is standing by. Thank you so much, CPS, for agreeing to speak with us on our flagship news. Let's begin with the figures of the disturbing report, because there are conflicting reports indeed. But walk us through just how many persons were killed in these latest attacks.
Thank you very much, Kelly, for having me. It's indeed a sad one, a sad story that in just under a week we are witnessing more attacks, and the Fulani herdsmen are not showing any sign of relenting. Your news rightly captured it. 13 persons were killed, and others injured. Some are missing as I speak with you, and the security agencies are aware of this. What Benue people are resisting is a situation where there will be lawlessness, because when the people resort to self-help now, we will plunge the state into a situation of anarchy. And that's why the governor of Benue State has been saying that a lot more can be done and should be done immediately to arrest the sponsors of these attacks. Their mode of operation now is that they are identifying the houses of members of the Benue State Livestock Guards, and they're going to their communities to attack and kill them in the effort of getting members of the state livestock guards, who they accuse of
All right.
the palms is the new weed. I've never seen a society where a group of people we vow never to respect the laws of the land. This is happening for the first time in my life.
Very sad and disturbing indeed. The question to also ask is just how is the Nigeria police force responding to these recent attacks?
It's clearly beyond the capacity of the Nigerian police. You understand that Operation Wildstrike is still in force in Benue, and even at that, the mode of attack of the Fulani herdsmen now is that they come at night between the hours of 1, 2, 3, and kill people in their sleep. Now, when day breaks, if youths of that area begin to agitate, of course, you would find that the conventional police will move in to prevent the breakdown of law and order. So they come, their tactic now is that they come when people are asleep, attack and kill, and retreat. When it's done, the police and other security agencies will move in. And so it's so painful that these people feel that I don't want to say if you want to face a people in a warfare, come out clearly and declare war against them. But you come when people are sleeping, attack them, kill even children, and do all that and run back. It's so disheartening what is happening. And we think that we know that there are people behind the Fulani herdsmen. Not every Fulani man is bad. We know very many good Fulani people. But the ones who are carrying AK-47 are the enemies of the state. And we wish that the state authorities, and when they say that, I mean the Nigerian state authorities, should identify the sponsors of these people and go after them, invite them at least for questioning. Why do you want to take over the land, the ancestral lands of the people? Where in this century are we still talking about conquests? Conquests were done before this century, and the world has moved to a globalized state, I mean, a civilized state with laws governing every society. And here are these people talking about conquests. It is unheard of. It is absolutely unheard of.
All right. CPS, just before we let you go, your principal, Governor Samuel Otom, made some very strong revelations a few days ago. Any response yet from the presidency?
Well, of course, you heard the presidential spokesman, Garba Shehu, come out to instead of addressing the issues that Governor Samuel Otom missed, he decided to go after the person, after the messenger, and left the message. And the message is very simple, that the president is the commander-in-chief of the armed forces of this country, and the law requires that he directs. No governor has the power to direct, to command even one policeman, not to talk of a soldier. So the presidency, the president and commander-in-chief, is the one who has the constitutional mandate to command security agencies. He gave a shoot on sight order, and his minister came out to contradict, to reverse that order, and nothing has been said about that. Instead of carrying out the order that Mr. President gave, the Minister of Defense came out and said that the persons who carry AK-47 should not be shot on sight, but arrested and prosecuted. I've never seen a country where the commander-in-chief we issue a directive, a presidential directive, and a minister, his appointee, will come out and contradict him and counter him. This is happening in Nigeria of ours today, and it is quite unfortunate, and we hope that this will not continue. Mr. President was elected by Nigerian people, and he has their mandate till 2023, and so Nigerians have a right to question. Nigerians have a right to have a say. They have a right to air their opinions, to call on him to perform better than what is happening as far as the concern. Life comes first. No matter what
well CPS, no matter CPS, I guess that's a good place to anchor a conversation with you. The network doesn't also seem very friendly. We'd like to thank you most kindly for speaking with the Benue State Governor, Teve Akase, live from Makurdi, the Benue State capital, about the very recent attacks just a few hours ago in Benue State, where reports says about 13 people have been killed, including children. Very sad indeed. Away from that, the